Hello everyone. I hope you guys are doing well. And today we are going to start with new unit, biodiversity and conservation. And it is unit 4 in our syllabus. So starting with the definition of biodiversity. Biodiversity or biological diversity is the sum of all different species of the plants, animals, fungi and microbial organisms which are living on the earth. Or biodiversity can also be defined as sum total of all types of diversity, that is genetic diversity, species diversity, and ecosystem diversity. Right? So sum total of all kinds of diversity, that is genetic diversity, species diversity, and ecosystem diversity is known as biodiversity. Term biodiversity was coined by Walter G. Rosen in 1985. Biodiversity plays an integral role in the way ecosystems work and in the benefits they provide. And we can also call biodiversity as variability and variations which are present among living organisms. Right? This definition was given by Convention on Biodiversity, which was an outcome of Earth Summit 1992, happened at Rio de Janeiro, Brazil. So in 1992, in Convention on Biological Diversity, this definition of biological diversity was given, right? So you can use any one definition, right? Here are some benefits of biodiversity, which includes regulating elements such as climate, water quality, disease and pollination, provisioning resources such as food, clean water, industrial raw material and genetic resources, and cultural promotions such as recreational activities, aesthetic purposes and spiritual benefits. These are the benefits of biodiversity. Moving towards the levels of biodiversity. So there are three levels of biodiversity. The first is genetic diversity, second is species diversity, and third is ecological diversity, also known as ecosystem diversity. Right? Let's see what is genetic diversity. It is clear by the name that it is the variations or variability present in the genetic material. Right? And this genetic material can be DNA or RNA. Mainly these are two genetic materials in the living organisms, both in plants and animals. And in primitive organisms like viruses, both DNA or RNA can be genetic material. In some viruses, DNA is genetic material, which is relatively more stable And in some viruses, RNA is the genetic material, which is relatively chemically unstable, right? So each individual is different on the basis of its genetic material, and no two individuals on the earth are similar because they have variations in the genetic material or in their DNA or RNA, right? So this variation is because of variability in the genes. And these genes are located on the chromosomes. And chromosomes are part of DNA, right? So if we talk about human beings, for example, so every physical characteristics in our body, जो भी फिजिकल एट्रीब्यूट्स होते हैं हमारी बॉडी में, ईच फिजिकल कैरेक्टरिस्टिक हैज अ डिफरेंट जीन, राइट? फॉर एग्जांपल, फॉर हेयर कलर, फॉर स्किन कलर, फॉर द कलर ऑफ आईज, फॉर द टाइप ऑफ हेयर, स्ट्रेट और कर्ली, राइट? फॉर द हाइट, राइट? सो ईच फिजिकल कैरेक्टर हैज अ सेपरेट जीन, राइट? So because of these variations in the gene, all the individuals are different, right? And this type of diversity or variation is known as genetic diversity. I hope it is clear. Members of a species share genes, and genes are bits of biochemical information that partly determines how an organism looks, behaves, and lives. Moreover, members of a species share integrate mating behaviors, right? Only the member of a same species can interbreed, right? And species is the basic functional unit of biological classification, right? All this imply that species have come from one common ancestor. However, they diverge and develop distinctive attributes with time and hence promote biodiversity in their own unique way. And this way to develop different attributes is known as evolution. Right? Now coming to the species diversity. So as we know, on our planet Earth, there are various kinds of species are present. So the wide variety of species which are existing in our environment is known as species diversity, right? And species is also the basic unit of biological classification, right? And when we talk about the ecological hierarchy, then species is at base, right? कई सारी species आपस में मिलके बनाती हैं पॉपुलेशन, एंड ग्रुप ऑफ पॉपुलेशन इज नोन एज कम्युनिटी. देन ग्रुप ऑफ कम्युनिटी इज नोन एज इकोसिस्टम. और जब कई सारे लैंड इकोसिस्टम मिल जाते हैं तो बनता है लैंडस्केप. And further, when there are so many landscapes are present, then it is known as biome, right? So species is at the base, and also it is the basic unit of biological classification, right? The number of various species in a given ecosystem or environment is described as species richness. जितनी डिफरेंट टाइप की स्पीशीज प्रेजेंट होंगी तो उसको बोलेंगे स्पीशीज रिचनेस. द टोटल नंबर ऑफ स्पीशीज इन द वर्ल्ड इज अबाउट 10 मिलियन. However, only 1.75 million species have been named scientifically till date, right? So it is an estimate that there are 10 million species on Earth, but scientifically अभी तक हमने जो हमारे पास record है और जिन species की naming की जा चुकी है उनका number है 1.75 million, right? Some regions may have many species, like some geographical regions may be rich in biodiversity or species richness can be high. For example, tropical North and South America, which is having 85,000 flowering plants, and tropical subtropical Asia is having at least 50,000 flowering plants species, right? And similarly, the subtropical Africa is having 35,000 species of flowering plants. Conversely, all of the Europe is having about 11,300 vascular plant species only, right? So this is how a particular biogeographical region may have high species richness and some have low species richness, right? Coming to the ecological diversity, which is also known as ecosystem diversity. And it is a variety of ecosystems in an area. Kitne different types of ecosystem present hain ek particular environment mein, it is known as ecological diversity or ecosystem diversity. And it involves the complex network of various species which are present in the ecosystem and their dynamic interaction among them. ठीक है एंड ऑल्सो विद द एबायोटिक कॉम्पोनेंट राइट एंड एज यू नो एन इकोसिस्टम इज मेड अप ऑफ ऑर्गेनिजम्स फ्रॉम सेवरल डिफरेंट स्पीशीज लिविंग टुगेदर इन एन एनवायरमेंट एंड देयर कनेक्शन थ्रू द फ्लो ऑफ न्यूट्रिएंट्स एनर्जी एंड मैटर राइट एंड इकोसिस्टम कैन कवर अ स्मॉल एरिया लाइक अ पॉन्ड और अ लार्ज एरिया लाइक एन एंटायर फॉरेस्ट एंड द प्राइमरी सोर्स of energy in an ecosystem is the sun. And in an ecosystem, the radiant energy of sun is converted into the chemical energy by the green plants by the process of photosynthesis, right? All of this we have studied in the second unit, that is ecosystem. It is difficult to measure ecological diversity because every ecosystem on the earth merges into the surroundings ecosystem, right? तो जितने भी ecosystems होते हैं वो एक convergence में present होते हैं, right? एक साथ इनका interaction चल रहा होता है, right? So there are few examples of some ecosystem which are having very high biodiversity. For example, tropical rainforest. Right? Also known as lungs of the planet. Similarly, any kind of forest we can say, right? Similarly, there are aquatic ecosystems like freshwater ecosystem, rivers, like oceans, like sea, like wetlands. Also known as kidneys of the earth, and oceans are also having very high biodiversity, right? So these are the few examples of ecosystem. So this is all about the ecological diversity. Now coming to the another topic, India is mega diversity nation, right? India has been described as one of the 12 mega diversity countries which are having very high biodiversity, right? So other mega diversity nations are Brazil, Peru, Ecuador, right? China, Myanmar, Madagascar, मैक्सिको, ऑल दीज आर द मेगा डाइवर्सिटी नेशंस, राइट? एंड देर आर 34 बायोडाइवर्सिटी हॉटस्पॉट्स विच सपोर्ट अबाउट 50,000 एंडेमिक स्पीशीज ऑफ प्लांट एंड कंप्राइजिंग 20% ऑफ द वर्ल्ड्स टोटल फ्लोरा. एंड इंडिया इज हैविंग 3 बायोडाइवर्सिटी हॉटस्पॉट्स विच वी विल स्टडी इन डिटेल. Forest, which embrace a sizable portion of biodiversity, now comprise about the 64 million hectares, or about 19% of the land area of the country. And Indian flora comprise about 15,000 flowering plants, and bulk of our rich flora is to be found in the northeast, western Ghats, northwest and eastern Himalayas, Andaman Nicobar Islands. Similarly, Assam and Western Ghats are home to the several species of mammals, birds, reptiles, and amphibian fauna, right? Also, we are the oldest and largest agricultural society, so we are having very high biodiversity of crops, or we can say cultivated crops. So we are having 166 species of crop plants and 320 species of wild relatives of cultivated crops, right? And it may be a matter of surprise that all this biodiversity is mainly conserved by, almost 90% of biodiversity of our country is being conserved by the tribal community, which is only 7.5% of the India's population, right? So to a large extent, the survival of our biodiversity depends on how best the tribals are looked after, right? We will talk about this in detail in our unit 7. So in order to preserve our rich biodiversity, there are 18 biosphere reserves in our country. Out of these 18 biosphere reserves, 9 are particularly in the specific biogeographical regions. Biogeographic zones ke bare mein we will talk about in next lecture. And the biggest one is in Deccan Peninsula. And it is Nilgiri Biosphere Reserve, covering Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, and Karnataka. Few others are Nanda Devi in Uttarakhand, which is in Western Himalayas, Nokrek in Meghalaya, which is in Eastern Himalayas, Manas in Assam, Sundarban in Gangetic Plain, and Great Nicobar, Gulf of Mannar in Tamil Nadu, right? So these are the few important biosphere reserves of India. Now coming to the biodiversity hotspots. So a biodiversity hotspot is a biogeographic region with a significant reservoir of biodiversity. And also it is under threat from the humans, right? So according to the Mayer's 2000 edition of biodiversity hotspot map, a region must meet two strict criteria to be called as a biodiversity hotspot, right? The first criteria is it must contain at least 0.5% or 1500 species of vascular plants as endemics. And it has to have lost at least 70% of its primary vegetation. So there are two criteria. The first criteria is it should have 1500 species of vascular plant as endemics. What are endemic species? So let's see. This concept of biodiversity hotspot was given by Norman E. Mayer. Right, and the first criteria was that it should have high degree of endemism and should have at least 1500 species of vascular plants as endemics. So endemic species are those species which are, yeah, whose distribution is particularly limited to a particular geographical region. whose distribution is restricted to a particular geographical region, and this type of species are known as endemic species. For example, there are few species which are only found in a particular geographical region, and they are not found anywhere else in the world. For example, like red panda, and it is endemic to the northeast. Similarly, orchids, they are also endemic to the northeastern region of India, right? And the second criteria was it has to have lost at least 70% of its vegetation, right? Means jo biodiversity ke jo loss hai uska jo rate hai it should be high in that area, then only that region can be called as biodiversity hotspot, or it can be declared as a biodiversity hotspot, right? And around the world, how many biodiversity hotspots are there? 34, right? And these hotspots support nearly 60% of the world's plant, bird, mammals, reptiles, amphibians, with a very high share of endemic species, right? So in India, there are three biodiversity hotspots. The first is the Western Ghats and Sri Lanka. The second is Eastern Himalaya. And the third is Indo-Burman region, right? So Western Ghats are chain of hills that run along the western edge of peninsular India, and their proximity to the ocean and through the orographic effect, they receive very high rainfall, right? And these regions have moist deciduous forest and the rainforest. So the whole area which is along the western coast, and this hilly region, this is known as Western Ghats, right? This region have very high species diversity as well as high levels of endemism, and nearly 77% of the amphibians and 62% of the reptiles species found here, and these species found nowhere else. Means 77% species of the amphibians and 62% species of the reptiles are endemic to Western Ghats, right? Next biodiversity hotspot of India is Eastern Himalaya. The Eastern Himalaya is the region which contains Bhutan, northeastern India, southern and center, and eastern Nepal. This region is geographically young and shows high altitudinal variations. And it is having nearly 163 globally threatened species, including the one-horned rhinoceros, the wild Asian water buffalo, and all 45 mammals, 50 birds, 17 reptiles, and 12 amphibians. Also 36 species of plants, right? This region is also home to the only salamander species which is found in India, also known as Himalayan newt. And this is an amphibian species, right? So this is all about the Eastern Himalayas. Our third biodiversity hotspot is Indo-Burman region. Indo-Burman region encompasses several countries such as Eastern Bangladesh, Malaysia, Northeastern India, which is south of Brahmaputra River, Myanmar, and southern part of China's Yunnan province, Democratic Republic of Laos, Cambodia, Vietnam, and Thailand. So these are the countries which covers this Indo-Burman region, this whole biodiversity hotspot, right? The Indo-Burman region is spread over 2 million square kilometers of tropical Asia. And in recent times, Six species of mammals have been discovered here. For example, large antlered muntjac, Annamite muntjac, gray shank dog, Annamite striped rabbit, leaf deer, and Saola. Almost 1300 bird species are also found in this region, including the white-eared night heron, gray-crowned grouse, and orange-necked partridge. Right, so these are the species which are found in the Indo-Burman region, and this is all about the biodiversity hotspots of India. I hope it is clear. So, in next lecture, we will start with the biogeographical regions in the India, right? Thank you.